Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Sunday Omony. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing and be sure to like this video as well. Also, don't forget to turn on the notification bell. This way you'll be notified every single time I upload a new video on my channel. So in this video, we're going to be talking about the former Real Housewives of Atlanta star Porsha Williams on vacation, allegedly in her new home in Costa Rica that she purchased, in my opinion, for her and her fiance, Dirty Simon, aka Simon Guobadia. So you guys were asking me if I did see the clip of Porsha playing with water guns, ignoring her child, and how Simon this time around is no longer even bringing his children on holidays and vacation. But I think it's because Porsha has demanded for PJ to come along. That's the only reason why her daughter is coming on vacation now. I think that she's noticed people have been asking, where is your daughter? Why are you so busy being a jet set babe instead of focusing on being a mother? I do believe that Porsha is crazy in love with Simon. I really do, you guys. She is crazy in love with him, but he is not crazy in love with her, in my opinion, just based on my observation of these people. And I want to talk quickly as well about the nannies. So anyway, Porsha was being filmed by her fiance, Dirty Simon, and then all of a sudden he turns the camera over to check out the nanny that's caring for the children. There were some other children there too. I don't know whose children those are that Simon has also brought along. Maybe he's allowed the nanny to also bring her children along as well, but they're not his kids. And the nanny is there with PJ, who is Porsha's daughter, but then there's two other children that I'm not sure whose children they are. But Simon, all of a sudden, when Porsha goes, you know, off onto the, like, the beach side or whatever, because there's a swimming pool, then there's, like, the, you know, the beach and the sand and stuff, she runs off over there and she thinks that Simon is filming her still, and his attention is just not really focused on her. Once again, we saw this happen before, allegedly, based on how it appeared to us, that Simon is never really paying close attention to Porsha, you guys. And are we surprised over here? No, we're not. You guys see the exact same things we see. Like, I see our observations, you guys, are mutual. We see things the same way. Like, I don't see things different from you guys. We see things the same way. You know, it is what it is. This man, I will not be surprised if he tries to get with one of Porsha's you know, friends, nanny, or even the maid. I would not be surprised. The nannies are very attractive too, you guys. Very attractive. Porsha was just busy acting like a teenager, of course, with the water guns, totally ignoring her child. But the nanny was just, you know, quiet in the corner, being there for the children. And as soon as Simon started giving her attention, you know, she just kind of flipped her booty to the side a little bit and just gave him a smile. And, you know, she was just really nice and cute and stuff like that. And you guys, you know how Simon is. This man is very interesting. He's a ladies man, very smooth. And you know how sometimes if some women are really desperate for money, they're, you know, nannies sometimes that are really desperate, you know, they're willing to also do whatever it takes. We think Porsha Williams is also desperate, but there are some nannies out here who also need a good life too, you guys. This is not just about Porsha Williams. There are nannies that are trying not to go back to their country. They want to go stay in the United States, in Europe, you know, they want to live in Canada. They just want a better life, and I really don't blame them, but they're gonna get that life through a lot of stress, and it's gonna be very dangerous, because when you're trying to do that with a man like Simon Guobadia, it's not gonna be easy, okay? Especially if you're a woman that's trying to come up and you're an opportunist, you're messing with the wrong man. Dirty Simon is not the kind of man who's generous. Everything he does, it's not for free. There's always a cost to it, all right? So just tread lightly when you're dealing with men like this. Be very careful. But anyway, the nannies are attractive. They seem really friendly. They do whatever they're told. And I don't blame them, because they have no choice, you know? If I was a nanny and I have to, you know what I mean? Like, I gotta dance and cheer and make Simon feel good about himself, and I'm being forced to do this by his fiance, Porsha Williams, I'm going to do it, you guys. If I have to be forced to do cosplay and wear an ugly pizza costume like one of the women had to do, and, you know, I need a job and I'm desperate, yes, I will have to do this, you guys. It just, you know, it is what it is sometimes. The struggle is real. The struggle is real. Yes, you don't have to do this if you don't want to, but if you really need the money, you will do it, right? You will do it. But anyway, until our next conversation, comment down below. Let me know your thoughts about this. Did you watch this clip of Porsha just totally ignoring her child? Why is she even having nannies at this point? Because she's quit basically all her jobs. All she does now is just sell bed sheets, and she can do that online. Every time she takes out her phone, she's always talking about Amazon and her bed sheets. And then she has her wig line, and that's it. As far as I'm concerned, her spinoff will just play, of course, but it's not like she's going to be doing like press tours, you guys. You know, Real Housewives of Atlanta. What kind of press tour do you even have to do for a show like that? You know, like, is she going to be having press tours? What show wants to have Porsha Williams on there to talk about her spinoff? Like, is this a, like, you know, docu-series? Is she Mariah Carey or something? Like, I don't know. Like, I don't see it happening, okay? I don't see it happening. She is a reality TV star, and that's pretty much it. So this is not like a docu-series that's like going deep into the life of Porsha Williams, because everything between her and Simon is a facade. It's not real. They're also like acting for the gram and doing the most. So I can expect that from the spinoff as well. So because she's not going to be doing major press tours and stuff, and she's in Costa Rica, she really could take care of her child. You guys, she really does not need the nanny. They did not need nannies for this trip. Was it necessary? Like, I don't know. Like, she's only working two jobs, and her jobs are now like online. Her hairline online, Amazon online. She's not really needed anywhere, right? Because she's done filming her spinoff. She's done with the Real Housewives of Atlanta franchise for now. But I know in the future she'll have to go back when she's desperate for money and when Simon has broken her heart. She will definitely go back. But until then, why the nannies, Porsha? But I know that she just did this because people have been asking where her daughter is. And Simon, I thought you were a family man. How come the other kids don't get to go on vacation? Why is it only PJ that's there? Where is this man's children, since he always pretends like he's such a family man? Where are they? How come they haven't been on any vacations lately, you guys? It's not fair. It's not fair. Anyway, I know life is not fair, but, you know, please, Simon, treat your children equally as well. But I know it's because Porsha demanded for her daughter to come along. But I'm sure that Simon probably didn't even want the daughter to come along. He probably wanted it to be him and Porsha. Or actually, to be honest with you, I can see that Simon probably wants it to just be him and not her there. If he could get away from her at this point, I could see him wanting a break from her. And you guys saw my previous video that I did, that Dirty Simon is not happy, you know, having to go everywhere with Porsha. Because during his relationship with his third ex-wife, Valentina, he was free, okay? He was like a single man in a marriage. He was able to go to yacht parties. He was able to go to the club. He was able to do so many things that, you know, his ex allowed him to do, and was at home babysitting and being a caregiver. But he was able to do all those things. But Porsha's a woman now that wants to be a jet set babe. Valentina didn't care about that whole lifestyle. She doesn't care about shopping. She doesn't care about the jets and all that kind of stuff. She just cared about family and the children, because somebody has to do that job, right? She can't just leave her children and just be a jet set babe. But Porsha, she has no problem leaving her child. No problem. Just to be a jet setter. She wants to be a yacht babe, a jet set babe, like you name it, you guys. Because she believes that she found an affluent man now, a millionaire. So now she's got to travel the world with him. Although she is sponsoring most of the stuff, it appears to me, in my opinion. Okay, I believe that Porsha contributed to this Costa Rica home. I don't believe that Simon just paid for this place. And by the way, why did Simon buy a place and Porsha buy a place in Costa Rica? I'm also hearing that Simon is not a US citizen and that he cannot be in the United States at certain times. He has to go somewhere for a bit and then always come back. This is what I'm hearing allegedly as well. So I don't know. You know, you guys, these people's lives are very bizarre, very interesting. But I thought I'll do the video because I did notice Simon's googly eyes again looking at the nanny. And Porsha, you need to be paying attention to stuff, but we know you're clueless and you're crazy in love. You're unaware of what's happening, but you need to, I would say for her to watch her man, but you know, we know this relationship's not going to last long. He's not a long-term man. He's a temporary man who's using her for her celebrity, you know, and fame and stuff like that. So anyway, Porsha, this is your tape. Until our next conversation, thank you so much for watching, everyone. And thank you for also listening to another view. But my view is not the only view. I look forward to hearing what you guys have to say as well down in the comment section. Be sure to connect with me on Instagram at SundayOmony if you're there, and also check out the video description and get your copy of my ebook. It's called More Than Good Enough, and I will talk to you guys next time. Take care of yourselves. Cheers.